Hi.
So this is a video about somebody who thinks they can figure something out, maybe thinks they even know what they're doing, but they don't actually know what they're doing. So in today's video, I am actually troubleshooting a Keystone jack because I had it hooked up, I thought I had it fixed, and apparently it's not. What's up YouTube? Jason here with Byte My Bits, and in today's video I am pretty much going to redo this Keystone jack. If you guys didn't follow some of my earlier videos before, I actually went through and wired a bunch of different Keystone jacks within the house, most of which are in the attic actually for cameras, and they've all seemed to work pretty well, except most of the cameras, they don't really need anything past 100 megabits per second. So I mean, apart from them working, I don't verify or know for sure whether or not they're running at full gigabit speeds. What I do know is that this Keystone jack is not running at the speeds it should, and it's fairly unreliable. And depending on how I plug in a cable, depends on whether or not I get a full gig speed. So it's kind of irritating, but sometimes I can plug it in and it'll pop up 1 gig right away. And sometimes I can plug it in, it'll kind of hang for a little bit, and then I'll only get 100 megabits per second. It kind of sucks. Now, to give a little bit of backstory here, when I got everything installed, I hooked it up, everything seemed to run fine, I got connection, everything seemed okay, but when I tried to use it for something, I noticed it didn't work very well, and I found out it wasn't working. I redid this one and the one that's actually located next to my switch once already, and I thought I fixed it, but apparently I didn't. So I actually went through, replaced both Keystone installations already once, and I still have the same problem, which kind of worries me on a couple levels. The first level is this whole thing is kind of idiot proof, really. I mean, everything's color coded here, so you don't have to look anything up. There's no weird way to mess it up. As long as you follow the generic, you know, guideline here, as far as, you know, the colors matching, you should be good to go. That and you use the right wires, but I don't know if I am. Basically, right now I have Cat 6A. It's actually fairly thick, pretty shielded cables that are running throughout the house, at least to this Keystone jack. So it's very possible maybe it's too thick wiring. I don't really know for sure. So I have a working theory here, and this is what I'm going to be doing today to troubleshoot this to see if I get a more reliable connection. And the working theory is maybe the shielding on the actual copper wires that are connecting to it, like on the inside of the Keystone jack, maybe for whatever reason, when I push them in, they're not being penetrated as much as they should, as far as being slit in the side and making connection with the sharp edge of the connector thingy to the actual wire. So what I want to do today is redo this, but strip the wire a little bit, so I know it's making connection. Because if I plug this in and kind of wiggle it a little bit, sometimes it'll come up 1 gig, sometimes it won't. So that's a little weird. I don't know what else to do. This doesn't work, which it's very possible it won't. I'm still gonna upload the video of me failing miserably, and you know, maybe somebody out there can help me. Or I could Google it. But that's not nearly as fun. I absolutely hate flathead screwdrivers. I hate them. Why do they exist? And why did I grab one? I have no idea. Okay, so as far as I can tell, I mean, this looks like everything is making a connection here. This side is supposed to cut into the wires, and it looks like it's making a connection. It looks like everything is good, but I just wonder if maybe this shielding is too thick, like the plastic shielding is too thick, that maybe it's just not allowing it to make a connection all the time. I don't really know, but everything seems okay. It's just, maybe it's not getting all the way through. I don't know. So I actually kind of wonder if I can't just take this knife and like scrape it on both of the installations and make it to where these are more exposed up here. And then when I plug it back in on both sides, it'll make a better connection. It's probably a horrible idea, but why not try? But now I have all of these wires pre-exposed, so when I stick this back on there, it should have a better connection. Maybe. There, everything looks like it's right here, so I think this is just a matter of... There we go. Lining this up like this. And from what I can tell, all of the wires actually did not recede in once I pushed this thing down. So I think I might be, good. Yeah, everything seems to be good. So all right, time to do downstairs one. Now the funny thing is that the reason why I'm even doing this and the reason why I even noticed is because of, I got this M4. This is from TP-Link. This is a like a mesh Wi-Fi system that they came out with. I'm working on a review on it and I wanna be able to get it the best possible results that it can do, you know, with actually like a good setup, and I'm hooking it up to my network and I was just not noticing good speeds. In fact, it was literally limited to like 98, 99 megabits per second. So obviously to me, if it's not going over 100 at all and it's just like stopping almost exactly at it, there was a problem with the wiring, which is literally why I even noticed. So now I gotta figure out the best way to get this jack out of here. You know, I ragged on the flathead. I did. But it's been useful, at least a couple times so far this video. You know, when you never set up something like this and you just like kind of wing things when you're building your little home lab network setup thing, you start to realize these little tips and tricks. Like, an easier way to get to this, for example, would be amazing. I mean, I can do it. It'd just be a lot nicer if it was easier. Now, it's a little hard to tell, but I think the brown wire didn't fully penetrate into it. So everything else, I can see the copper, but the brown, I can't see it. I don't know if that's just because of the contrast of the color of the copper wire and the brown, you know, protectant casing or insulation or whatever, or if it actually didn't penetrate. But either way, I'm going to cut them all and then re-expose it and then kind of hope this fixes it. I'll cut all that out though. Okay, I think this one was a little sloppier because I was felt like I knew what I was doing, so I kind of rushed through it a little bit, but I think it should be good still. Either way, I'm gonna try to put it back on and hopefully it doesn't pull the wires through. Now I'm just gonna take this upstairs and do a little test, see if this worked. Okay, now before, when I plug this in, and yes, I have to use a little USB connector because this laptop doesn't have one built in, but anyways, before when I plugged it in, not only would it take a long time, but sometimes it would work, sometimes it wouldn't. So now let's see how quick it is. Come on, you got this. Although it is showing 1 gigabit per second, so maybe this actually worked. Which would be very surprising if it actually worked. Kind of, okay, not very surprising, but let's check this out. Let's actually run a quick little test here and see if this is working as it should. I have a gigabit connection coming into the house, so really, it should be a lot faster than this. So I'm still hovering within the 180 range. Okay, so every server is giving me 170, 180 range. So I'm gonna go try to plug it into a different port in my switch. Okay, so the idea here, now that I change it over to a switch, is I actually have everything plugged in, like all these wires running through my Cisco power over Ethernet switch, and that runs to my HP switch. So the HP switch is kind of the main switch for everything, and the power over Ethernet goes to all these ports because that's what powers up my cameras. So now I just want to change server, try this one, and I want to see if maybe switching the switch switches it up a bit. I mean, it started off strong, but it's kind of going back down to that 180. I exposed all the wires, so I know it's making good connection. So shy of the actual Keystone jack itself, like them not having a close enough connection to get on the wires, because it has two of them and it connects and it like goes over them like this, and then it gets like that. That's how it looks, pretty much. But unless that's not close enough, I don't know. It should be. It looks like it is. It made enough to cut in the first time, so it should be close enough. All the wires are exposed, and as far as I know, this cable doesn't have any, like, you know, issues or flaws in the cable itself. So that's probably the last thing I could think. I mean, aside from actually putting a regular termination on these cables and trying it that way and basically bypassing the whole jack idea. But I don't know. I'm going to go downstairs and I'm going to plug this laptop directly into my switch and then see, you know, like what my speed is there. Just in case some reason I'm running slow tonight? I don't know. Let's check. Okay, so I am just running horribly slow tonight because 209, that is not my maximum throughput. Well then. So I ended up not wanting to take the internet's word for it as far as speedtest.net and relying on that to judge my internal network speed capability. So what I ended up doing was just creating a shared folder on the laptop using another computer that was directly connected to one of the switches and ran like a file copy test. Now this was basically a 10 gigabyte video file that I encoded for my PSU installation video, that one that I uploaded to YouTube, and I was able to get 111, 112 megabytes per second. Now, something to keep in mind when it comes to bits versus bytes, 125 megabytes per second is equivalent to 1 gigabit per second. So getting 112 out of 125 is pretty decent. Definitely way better than what I was getting with Speedtest. So this whole like speedtest.net thing running slow, it's not uncommon for me to not be able to break 300 megabits per second, especially during these peak times. I mean, it's like 6 o'clock in the evening, so it's kind of expected to be a little bit slower than normal. But either way, it looks like I've solved the problem. So this kind of leaves me with a question. Is this the Keystone jack issue? I got these Keystone jacks from Monoprice actually. So as far as I know, they're pretty good Keystone jacks. Or is this a cabling issue? Like the shielding on the cable itself, is it too thick? Do I need to buy a different Keystone jack that's capable of handling this? I don't know. The cable itself is Cat 6A cabling. It's pretty thick and kind of difficult to work with as far as how thick it is and how it doesn't like to bend. But the Keystone jack is Cat 6A Keystones. So they're also heavily shielded and pretty beefy Keystone jacks. So I don't know where the disconnect here was. I would like to just say it's safe to assume that it was probably a user error on my part. It just kind of throws me off that not only did I do this once and then have these exact same issues, but I did it twice on both Keystone jacks. I snipped them off, redid the wiring, didn't strip them, but you know, put the wiring in the Keystone jack, shoved it down. And I mean, I went through the entire installation twice for both Keystone jacks, and then I had the exact same issue. And now when I go through and I strip the wires and I put the Keystones back on, all of a sudden I have a gigabit connection and it's reliable. I've unplugged it and plugged it back in multiple times. Every time it comes up, it registers at 1 gigabit per second and I don't have any issues. It was just a matter of me verifying that the speed was there, which it was. So moving forward, if I'm going to use these Keystone jacks, which I will because I still have them, I will pretty much just strip those wires where those areas are. Strip them the right way instead of, you know, jabbing at them with a knife, because that's horrible practice, probably. But I'm horrible at this anyways. So, I mean, have you seen my backup battery installation? I don't do everything normal. I make it work though, usually. At the end of the day, I have everything working. I verified everything's reliable and I know that the speed is there. And I think maybe even later tonight, I'm probably gonna retest it with speedtest.net just to, you know, I don't know why, but I will. But I was able to do a file copy test and it was able to reach pretty good speeds, 112 megabytes per second out of 125. Considering I'm doing other stuff on the network, like, you know, using remote desktop and other things like that, 112, it's pretty reliable. Also, that was SSD to SSD, so I don't know. But hey, I'm welcome to judgments or criticisms or ideas, solutions here. You know, if you think I did something wrong or maybe I installed this wrong, I don't know. I'm kind of just assuming that I did something wrong. But if you have any comments for me, leave them down below. As always, guys, thank you for watching. Like and subscribe and have yourself a good night.